Cool. Well, while we're on the head theme, can we quickly talk about, there's a Patreon member who asked about, her name is Kat. She's getting ready to do some holiday cooking. Heads, can you make, well, would you roast a head that doesn't have cheeks on? Would it be worth it?
Yes, it would, but I would do it with the lid on. So it might be, depending on the fatitude of your pig, it might be prone to drying out. So that would be the drawback of that.
There's less fat.
Yeah, and the skin as kind of a moisture boundary that holds in the moisture and the liquid fat of the head has been compromised in the removing of the jowls. So a lot of the fat that is there might just kind of run out, you know, rather than hang out in the head and go with the meat clinging to the skull. So that is possible. This is what I would do. Cut it in half lengthwise. So you have a head without cheeks. Cut it in half from snout to the back of the head, right? You know, right between the ears, between the eyes, all the way down in half lengthwise.
You need a bone saw for that.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, use a bone saw. You could maybe do a hack job with a hacksaw.
Mm-hmm.
But that would be kind of dangerous. You'd have to have like a vise to hold it in and you'd be jiggling all over the place. You could do it with a cleaver, you know, or a good axe. If you rest the axe on it and beat it with a mallet, you know, then you won't have to swing it. That's one way, but I definitely prefer the saw. Cut in half lengthwise, and then depending on how the pig has been killed, I would, at that time, having cut it in half, remove the brain. Because the pig was shot with a bullet in the brain, the brain has lost its food value entirely. It's bone fragments, it's bloodshot, probably some lead.
So. That was actually one of our questions.
Yeah, so get it out of there, get the brain out. If I'm doing the head whole, I don't worry about getting the bullet.
Okay.
Yeah, and I use jacketed hollow points. And, you know, this is a particularity of my setup, is with jacketed hollow points, 90% of the time, the bullet stays somewhere in the brain cavity.
Uh-huh.
So it's usually in the skull somewhere. So I never see it when it roast a head whole.
That's right.
It's just, it's in there. It's pretty far from the meat, and I don't worry about it.
Okay.
When you cut the head in half, you do actually kind of then have the luxury to figure it out if you want.
Mm-hmm.
And you can search for the bullet. Just follow the trauma.
Mm-hmm.
Follow the bullet. I mean, if it looks like it's a bullet, it has. Follow that, and eventually you will find the bullet.
Mm-hmm.
And then if it's a jacket at hollow point, it'll usually be in two pieces. So you've cut the head in half, and then put half the head in your largest, heaviest enameled cast iron pot that has a lid. And put the head down on, you know, a bed of vegetables, like halved onions, you know, things that are big. Because you're going to cook it for a long time. If it's chopped too small, it can get totally funky and fried. So then put the lid on. In fact, you can even do this in hay. You can do a head in hay. You can put wonderful hay in there and make sure none of it is protruding. From the lid, when you put the lid on, dump in a half bottle of white wine, and then put that in the oven at a low temperature, lid on. So what you're doing is locking in all the moisture. And it's not like the head doesn't even have to be submerged in anything. You know, the wine is really just for aromatics and just to kind of keep things moistish in there. And it'll be a wonderful sauce at the end. But roughly the same cooking time, you know, it probably won't take as long actually, but roughly the same, you know, do the salt and olive oil thing all over the head, cut a whole bulb of garlic, the whole thing in half, and just put that in there.
Okay.
Whole sprig of rosemary, you know, half bottle of wine, what else? A little slosh of brandy maybe.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe a little bit of stock. But again, you don't, that stuff is just in small amounts. You don't even need to submerge the head. And then aromatic vegetables. So lovage is really great for this. The leaves and radishes. The whole radishes in there. Leaves attached. Don't even cut. And then just let that go. Again, you know, 325 in the oven for several hours.
Okay. Kind of like you braise a shoulder or something.
Yeah.